Next one, the history objects. As I said you, for every topic in this window object, we have properties, collections, and methods. Let me see the purpose of this history objects. To make some the previous history of browsing the things in that window of any type of browser, to access that one, we are going to using this history object. Now in this history object, we have properties and methods. Let me see the history object properties. In this, we have the properties like length, current, next, previous. We can calculate the length of the history. Based on that, we can say whether the history is full or not. The current history in the sense currently which URLs you are going to browsing. Next in the sense, just now the previous, which type of elements of histories you are going to access, right? Next, previous. So these are the four different properties are available for history. Coming to the history object methods, in the history object methods, it will be have the methods like back, forward, go. So back, forward, go. These are the three methods are available for accessing of this three methods, back, forward, go, right? So the properties are length, current, next, previous, and the methods are back, forward, go, right? So let me see one example in this history of this. Now, history, yes, see the program for this one. In the body, I'm just creating a form. Inside the form, I'm just creating a button of name called as activity. When I click on this button, it will show, it will trigger the function, JavaScript function, that is show count. In the show count, what I'm writing here is history to calculate the length, history.length. You have visited his count web pages so far. Means, did you observe some of the website has the number of visits in the bottom of the page, there is a number of visits, right? How they are calculated, the number of visit means with the help of history.length method. So this is one property, sorry, history.length is our property. With the help of this, it is going to be accessing. Let me run the program. It will just tell you how many number of times you are visited for this. So far, you have visited. So you have visited web pages so far. You have visited means it is one. Hope it is hiding one here. Visited one. Between visited web page, web, there is a one is count is there. Just I will go for two. This is visited. If you want to be increasing the number of times, how many number of times you are going to be visiting, you can access. You have visited this count, hist count over this web pages so far, the number of times. Now, if you run the same program in another browser, like Firefox, for example, just I'm zooming in. If you see this, you have visited so and so. The count is one. Like if you are going on increasing, like it is asking you for preventing the things not shown to the dialog box, right? So with the help of this properties, with the help of these properties and the methods, you can access the number of times you are going to be visiting this page. History of this. Not only this, we can also have the other example. In the next objects, we'll see in detail about some little more about the history objects as well. Coming to the next subheading under the screen objects. So screen objects are going to displaying for the screen of a browser. Now in this screen object, we have like the objects, how to access the screen is window.screen. Now coming to the property, what are the different properties are available for this screen is, to access the screen property, screen.property name. The properties are avail height, avail width, the color depth, height, pixel depth, width. These are the some of the properties are available for this. So let me have run a small example. In this one, in the screen properties, because for screen property only we have one subheadings, if you remember or not, we have only the screen properties, there is no methods and collections. I'll just go for the screen property program. This is the screen property we are writing. So just I am writing a script document.writeln. What I am displaying, the current browser, height, its width, available width, available height, the color depth, pixel depth.
All these sort of properties I'm going to display over here. Just run the program.
See the properties which is going to displaying for this screen. Total height is 768. The total width is 1368. Available is undefined. Available height is 726 up to we can go. The color depth is 24
and pixel depth also 24. If you run the same program in another browser, maybe if you are running the IE, for example, if you run this in the same IE, it is having the different.
Let's see, the total height is 512. The total width is 91. Width is undefined. Mac available height will can go for 485. Still we have left it 485 height. The color depth 24
and pixel depth also 20. Like this, if you are changing from browser to browser, the program
property will be display in a different way. Okay, so that's about the screen object. Coming to the location object. Location object talks about the location object talks about in this one, understanding the location object, it talks about how to access the location window dot location. So window dot location, it will gives you, for example, to know to move or to assign a URL to a particular location, window dot location equal to, we can assign this value to this one, right? So in this window, it will consisting of the two features. One is the properties, another is methods. Properties, another is methods. Now location object property, it is going to be accessing the properties over here. Like in this one, the properties are, say for example, href, the address is required. Protocol, which protocol you are going to be using over this. The host and host name. So host and host name talks about, like the host name is the domain where you can represent over there. And subdomain also, if you want, you can represent in host name. Protocol, which type of protocol you are going to be using, HTTP or FTP or HTTPS. And href is the website address where it is located, means URL. Now coming to this, this is one example we'll see later. We'll directly move to the next location object methods. The methods over here is assign, reload, replace. Assign, reload, replace is the three methods are available for doing of the properties. With the help of this methods, we can access the locations over in the window. So the properties are available is href, the protocol, and host, host name. And the location object methods are assign, reload, replace. So these are the methods and the other properties. Let me see the example. Let me run this program on locations. Location one, let me see the first one. Location one, where in this program, what I'm doing here is coming to the body. In the body, just I'm creating a paragraph H1. Just I'm displaying the message. I'm creating a form. The name of the form is LOC. The method, let me see, talk about later in the third unit about this post. And protocol, select name protocols. I'm going to be creating a select button where I'm giving the option to the user which type of protocol like to be accessed. HTTP is one option. File is another option. JavaScript is another option. FTP is another option. Mail to is another option. These are the different protocol fields we are having. We are going to select any one of the protocol. And again, the second is host name. For this host name, what I'm doing is I'm creating a text field of size 23 and maximum length is 256. Name of this text field is host name field. Now default, I'm just giving as dreamtechpress.com over here. And next, if you want to be access anything in subpart, give the path name over here. The path name I'm mentioning, another tag I'm going to using path name as a label. I'm creating another label text field for this label path name. The size is 20, maximum length is 100. The name is path name field over here. Now, the last I'm just creating a button. Just I'm creating at the last a button. Go is a button name. When I click on that button, it go to the particular page, go to page. Now go to page is a JavaScript function. Now in this JavaScript function, go to page, what it is doing? It is window.location.href. Like to access the location, what we need to use? Window.location.href. So equal to, we are accessing from where it is accessing window.document. Where is the document here? In this document, HTML document, LOC is the form name. Protocol field name is going to be, this is the field name. Protocol field name is the name. Whatever the protocol you are going to be using, that will be assigned entirely to this window.location.html. followed by dot options. Options means what here? In this option, options is whatever you are selecting. Here the different options are there, right? You are selecting one options over here. That option, it has to be selected, that whichever it is going to be selected, pick that, take that text, whatever it is entering into the text field, plus the hostname field value. What is the hostname field value you are going to give? That hostname field value, where it is here. The hostname field value is www.dreamtech.dreamtechpress.com. That totally, plus the path name field. The path name field you are giving at the last. Here you are giving the path name field, that value. So that total details it is going to be accessing by go to page function. Let me run the program so that you can get some idea over here. Hope it is visible. Now what you are doing here is,
here I am creating a protocol. We can have file protocol, JavaScript, FTP, mail too. And host name default is like this, and path is this one. If you click on go, if you have an internet, automatically it will open dreamtechpress.com. Automatically your program will open it. If you want a particular path inside this, if you are enter into any path over here, it is a dreamtech.com. If you go for a catalog, if you enter into a catalog over here, if you say, for example, multimedia, like 3D Max, if you are displaying this, 3D Max.
So this is the another path value here. If you want to come in directly to this, if you want to directly come to this, you can use this path name as a field over here in our program. You just paste here and click on go.
Once you click on go, instead of going to the dreamtechpress.com, it directly go to this catalog which is we just now visited. That is called as path name here. Path name means after the main website, what is the sub menu or sub page you want to be visited. That visiting sub menu we need to give as a path name field here.
Okay. For example, if you want www.google.com, also you can access. Just you can use slash initially.
It will open google.com. Like this, it goes to google.com. Like this, we can make sure of all this. So this type of programs, it is very helpful for you while you are developing a new websites for you, or when you are developing a new apps sort of. It can be helpful for you. See the another example in the location, where in this example we are just replacing. I'm creating a two buttons. One is for DreamTrek, another button is for Google URL.
So for assign, initially it is DreamTechPress. For replace is another function. Just I'm replacing.
For assign is initially the window.location assign is DreamTechPress. When I click on that Google URL, it will replace with window.location.replace with this Google.com. So in this one, assign is one method, in location object, and replace is another method.
Okay, so just run the program.
So when you run this program, it is showing two buttons for you. DreamTechPress URL, right? It is opening that. Fine. Now when you click on this Google URL, it will be replaced with google.com. Okay, so like this, you can do any type of the objects, any type of things over here. So in this topic, what we have discussed? We have discussed about the history objects here. We have discussed about history objects. Under this, we have discussed properties, methods. And in screen objects, we have discussed only the properties. And in location object, we have discussed about properties and methods, and also with respect to programs. And all these programs already there. Please work out for all this program. And if you have any doubts, let me know. Okay. So in this class, we have discussed about all this. Window object properties, navigation object properties, history object, screen object, location object. That's about this browsers, built-in browsers in JavaScript, built-in browser objects in JavaScript.